Get ready to match the stars. Dick Gautier. Barbara Stewart. Jack Carter. Joanne Pflug. Richard Dawson. And Shelley as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Raver.
I think we're going to have another go at it, don't you?
Yes.
I guess for the uninitiated, if you weren't with us last time, Dick Gautier and Barbara Stewart are husband and wife.
Oh, I hope so. I hope so. They're dressing with me.
And you know since last time what happened?
What?
We split up.
No, but listen, you know what else? Last time, Barbara, you were a redhead, weren't you?
Well, yes, but you see, my husband gets bored very easily.
Oh, yes. So we like to play roles.
Have a little Mickey Mouse suit and a goofy hat.
Okay, I got the idea. I got the picture. Well, those are our celebrities. Now let's say hello to our two players. Here are Jeff Nichols and Donna Weiser. Now, this fella here, Jeff, he's our current champ. He's got $9,850 to his credit. He's won six games. He's already started the game with Donna. They've played one round, haven't they?
Yes.
And we've got to play the second and final round. And he's ahead, 5-1. And we'll see how it all turns out right after this.
I'm so excited, Gina. I can't stand it.
Okay. Round one has been completed. We go to round two, and as we do that, I remind Donna she must match four celebrities to stay in the game.
Yes.
Okay?
I'll try.
Make your selection, challenger.
One from column A.
All right, here it is. One from column A. And everybody plays. Folks, this is it.
Wait a minute. Mine says don't write.
That's right.
Thank you for reminding me of that.
Okay, Gene.
You see, in the previous round, Donna had already matched Dick Gautier,
right.
So Dick Gautier,
luckily,
you lay
he
out
can
and
anyway.
You'll try and match everyone else. All right. John wouldn't mind being shipwrecked on a desert isle with blank. John wouldn't mind being shipwrecked on a desert isle with blank. Okay, we're all set with the celebrities. You ready, Jack, right? Okay,
yes.
This is it. All right, now, Donna Weiser, we call for your response. John wouldn't mind being shipwrecked on a desert isle with...
A beautiful girl.
A beautiful girl. All right. Let's see how many of our celebrities here have said that. Barbara.
A beautiful girl.
A beautiful girl.
Well, I named a beautiful girl.
Yeah, well, we can't match
Raquel
that.
Raquel Welch.
Raquel Welch. All right. Now, you must match all the remaining celebrities to stay in the game. And let's go on and see what Jack has. We're looking
well,
for a beautiful
well,
girl.
It's not... Raquel Welch isn't a boy either. I went the same route.
So, that does not match, and that means Jeff Nichols has won another game.
Oh, I'm so bored.
It's another $100 for you for winning the game, and we'll say goodbye to this pretty lady. We thank you very much for being with us. We have a gift for you, Donna. Let's say goodbye to Donna Weiser.
Does he know how boring it is for us to sit up here and watch the same guy with a red coat win over and over again? $10,000?
Seventh game, you got $9,950, and here is another go at the super match, you know, where you can go a lot, as you know, because you've done it once before. All right, let's get right to it now. We polled a previous studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Tooth blank. Tooth blank. Now, the answer given most often by that studio audience is worth $500 if you can match it, the second, $250, and the third, $100. The celebrities will give you a hand, so let's get right to it. Choose three celebrities and get their responses. Number one, if you please.
Joanne Pflug.
Joanne Pflug? How do you fill in that blank? Tooth. What's that?
Go with the winner.
All right.
Toothpaste.
Toothpaste is what she says. Okay.
Shelley Winters.
Toothache.
Toothache is what Shelley says. All right. And one more.
Jack Carter.
Well, I was thinking of Gabby Hayes, toothless.
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 That's what he says, toothless. Okay, so your celebrities have given you toothpaste, toothache, toothless. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. But right now, we need an answer.
I'll go with Joanne. Toothpaste.
Toothpaste is what he said. Now let's find out how that audience responded. We are looking for toothpaste. And now let's see the $100 response. Toothbrush. Okay, you got half of it now. We're looking for toothpaste. May we see the $250 response? Toothpaste it is. There it is. Okay, you got the $250, and now you can play for 10 times that amount. But first, let's find out what's in back of that $500 response. Yeah. Toothache. Shelley gave you that one. That was your answer, Shelley. Good answer. Okay, now...
If toothache, he'd have had another $5,000?
No.
No, he would have won another $250 and qualified to go for $5,000. Now he's qualified to try for 10 times $250 or $2,500, and you're going to do that by matching a celebrity head-to-head, so let's turn around and choose a celebrity first.
Could I be a contestant next time?
Joanne Pflug.
All right.
What else?
Joanne, you get ready to write. You face me, Jeff, as you have so many times before. I'll get the question. Here we go. It's worth $2,500. So, Joanne, are you all set there? All right, give us your response to this. Write it down. Telephone blank. Telephone blank. All right, Joanne is finished, and now, Jeff, we ask for your response to this $2,500 question. Telephone
book.
Book is what he says. Joanne, for $2,500, may we see your answer?
I said pole.
Pole! This is telephone pole, telephone book. They're both good answers here.
You're an old line worker.
Well, all right. So now you're up to... You broke the $10,000 mark, though, with the additional $250. You're up to $10,200, and you're going to meet another challenger after this commercial. Now let's say hello to this new challenger, Helen Molnar. Hi there. You want to say hello to Helen there, Jeff? And wish her well, as she wishes you well. Helen, would you tell us a little about yourself, if you please?
I'm married to an accountant. We have three wonderful kids, two of the audience down there.
The two down there, they are darling little kids. And where do you live?
Cheviot Hills.
Okay, nice to have you with us.
Thank you.
You know that you and Jeff will be answering questions?
He scares me.
He's a formidable opponent, I must say. You'll be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrities. You'll get two chances. The one who's done that the most at the end of the second round wins, gets $100, and a chance to go at the super match for over $5,000. I will push the button, revealing these two questions. The challenger makes the selection. Show, if you would, please.
I'll take B.
B is what she wants. Here is a new game, folks, so you will all participate, and this is your assignment.
I hope this is a good one, Gene.
The last thing Helen does before going to bed is blank. Her name happens to be Helen.
Can I confer with her at all?
No.
Find out her private habits, right?
The last thing Helen does before going to bed is blank. What's that? Did you finish? Did you put it in the slot?
No, I'm writing. I'm thinking. Is there any time to think?
This is not a thinking man show.
I'm a woman.
A thinking woman show.
Put me down for $2.
That's what she's putting.
Okay. Now she's finished, and we'll ask Helen Molnar for her response. The last thing Helen does before going to bed is...
brush her teeth.
Brush her teeth is what she says. I guess you like that. You like that answer? All right, let's see if these people thought of that. Dick Gautier, what does she do before she goes to bed? Brush her teeth?
No, you brush your teeth. The last thing you do is turn out the light.
Oh. Turn out the light.
Yeah, let's hear it. So turn out the light, folks.
That's a very fickle audience. Yeah. First they applaud brush your teeth, now they're applauding. What do you say?
That's wrong. That's before you go to sleep, not before you go to bed.
Hold everything.
No, wait a minute. Are we discussing semantics here?
Besides, you never turn out the
May light. May we see your response,
and you never brush
Barbara.
Your teeth.
Shall we get on with it, folks?
Welcome to the newlywed game.
Brushing her teeth.
Thank you, Matt, Helen. There's one for you. Okay, Jack?
I was hoping she'd brush her teeth, that she'd do it in the shower.
In the shower. So there's no match there.
Shower.
Brush teeth is her answer. Joanne, what's yours?
That's my answer. Brush
That's yours. You scored twice now, Helen. And now...
always remember, cleanliness is next to godliness. So brush your prayers.
Brush your prayers.
Okay. Brush the teeth.
Well, you Helen. Put out the cat, but then you brush your teeth.
No.
Put out the cat is her answer. So you've scored twice, and now let's go to Jeff's end
times,
of this round. Two times over there. And here we go. Ready, Jeff? All right, you all play. Listen carefully.
Yeah.
Doris was surprised when she discovered her husband was a blank.
Say it again.
All right, here it is.
Just a minute.
Wait a minute. I don't think they all heard it. Audience, but they've got it. Doris.
Doris?
Doris.
Doris.
Doris was surprised when she discovered her husband was a blank. Did you hear that? All right, you formulate an answer while they're writing there.
And Doris is going to...
better write an answer there.
I have a friend, Doris. No matter what I write down, she's going to be mad at me.
Well, this will not apply to your friend, Doris.
This is a mythical Doris.
A mythical Doris.
Was a. Not was.
Doris was surprised...
if you don't write an answer.
...when she discovered her husband was a...
A something.
Blank. Right.
What? Are they all through?
Everybody's through but you, Shelley.
We only got about a week. Yeah. And we got to leave. You go with Nichols to New Orleans.
All right.
Okay, just a minute.
All right, she's writing an answer, and there it is. Okay, now, Jeff, we'll call on you for your response. Doris was surprised when she discovered her husband was a...
swinger.
A swinger, is what he said. Let's see if that
swinger.
Happens up here. Okay, Dick Gautier, what do
well,
you say?
Well, I have essentially the same thing, except what he was swinging with was not maybe what you thought. I said fag.
That's his answer. Now let's go to Mrs. Gautier and see what she has to say.
Great minds run in the same pattern.
No.
I
also said fag. That's it.
Doris was surprised when she discovered her husband was a blank.
Was a person that when they got undressed their wedding night, he put on her clothes. She hasn't seen him since. I thought he was a girl.
A girl. Husband was a girl. Okay.
Looked good in her mules.
Got three weirdos up there. What do we get down here, Joanne?
Well, I was told by my mother, now no cracks, that the hardest thing to tell about someone is if they're an alcoholic or a drug addict. So I didn't follow my English rules. And I put a alcoholic, and it should be an alcoholic.
Oh, husband was a alcoholic.
Oh,
okay.
An alcoholic.
So,
I know.
She knows it now. Now, Mr. Dawson.
Yes, that was no fag. That was my lady.
A lady. All right. No match there. We're looking for the word swinger. Shelley, what do you say?
A rich man.
A rich man. So, you didn't score at all with that, Jeff. And at the end of round one, Helen is ahead 2-0. We'll go to round two, but first this. Second and final round of this game. Are you ready? Our challenger's ahead 2-0. All right, Helen, would you make a selection if you please?
I'll take B again.
B it is. And the last time you matched Barbara Stewart and Joanne Pflug, and now you'll be attempting to match the others. Melvin got his blank caught in a revolving door.
I've had it with this game. That's it.
Now, Jack, sit down there. Get back up there. And write an answer down there. Come on now, Melvin got his blank caught in a revolving door.
I know a girl, and they've been going around together ever since. All right, let's move.
And so you gotta refuse to take your clothes off in movies and refuse to talk on television. What was that?
Would you, would you write an answer, please? Melvin got his blank caught in a revolving door. Simple assignment, I would say.
Maybe simple for you.
Okay. Easy for you.
Everybody ready over there? So, Helen, we'll call on you for your response. Melvin got his blank caught in a revolving door.
His coat?
His coat is what she said. All right, Dick Gautier, what do you say?
I had a different answer, but I happen to know Melvin, and tie is the only thing that he could have gotten caught in a revolving door.
Okay. Jack, what do you say?
Coat, well, I wish, you know, the coat covers the arm, so I...
Got his arm caught in a revolving door. Her answer is coat. Richard, what's yours?
I only wish it were...
what is it?
Tie is his answer. Okay, Shelley, may we see yours? His what?
What is blank?
His blank.
His what? Blank.
Go to the second half of this round. Jeff, I remind you, it's 2-0 in her favor. You must match 2 celebrities to stay in the game. 3, however, will win it for you. And this is it. Susie got blank the night of her graduation. Did you hear that, Jeff? Yes. Susie got blank the night of her graduation. Everybody plays because he didn't match anybody in the previous round. All right. Now, Jeff, what do you say to that? How did you fill in that blank? Susie got...
kissed.
Susie got kissed the night of her graduation.
Oh, how sweet.
All right, you need 2 to stay in the game, 3 to win. Dick Gautier.
Well, if you knew Susie like I knew Susie, you'd know that she got pregnant on the night.
Okay.
Oh, God.
No match there. Now,
oh,
Barbara,
boy.
What do you say?
Well, I said stoned, and you can take that either way.
Okay. No match there.
He does all my best material. I should be in that seat, because if you know Susie like I knew Susie, she also didn't get kissed or got pregnant.
She got pregnant, instead.
We all knew the same girl.
His answer is she got kissed the night of her graduation.
They are really tacky.
What do you say, Joanne?
Maybe she got drunk.
She got drunk the night of her graduation.
And she got kissed. Okay.
Well, that's what's causing
We're
her getting,
getting
pregnant.
Precipice here, Jeff, because you must match Richard Dawson and Shelley Winters to stay in the game. All right, Richard.
Well, I guess I have good news and bad news. She got goose.
Talk in a moment, but first, I've got to thank Jeff for being with us. You've been a good champion. You have won a lot of money, 7 games, $10,200. Wow. Jeff, it's been great having you.
Thank you.
Jeff Nichols. What's that? It's very gracious of you to say that, Helen. It really is. She said it. It couldn't have happened to a nicer guy, and he really was a swell fella, and he's got a lovely family. They've been out here supporting him, and I'm very happy for him. I'm happy for you, too. Now, you got $100 to begin with, and here it is. The super match is about to begin. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay. We polled a previous studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank sticks. Blank sticks. The answer given most often by that bunch is worth $500 if you can match it. And the second, $250, and the third, $100. You know how that goes? 3 of these people are going to help you. You'll choose them one at a time and get their responses, and then use one of them if you want. Now pick your first celebrity.
Joanne.
You know, the only thing I can think of is pickup sticks.
Pickup sticks.
Me too.
Okay, that's one response. You want to choose another celebrity?
Richard?
Drumsticks.
Drumsticks is what he says. All right, one more.
I'll go with Dick.
Dick, what do you say?
Those were the two I had in my mind.
Wait a minute. Matchsticks.
Matchsticks. Okay, that's the third one. Pickup sticks, drumsticks, matchsticks. Do you want to use one of those, or do you want to give us one of your own? The audience is urging her to use chopsticks. Let her make up her own mind.
I think I'll go with chopsticks.
Yes.
You will. Okay. She's looking for chopsticks. May we see the $100 response? Matchsticks. That was his. All right. We're looking for chopsticks. The $250 response. Pickup sticks. That's up there, too. Joanne gave you that one. Here's your third and last chance. We're looking for chopsticks.
Chop.
May we see the $500 response?
Chops.
Chop. Oh, chop. Okay. I'll come back to this excited lady in a moment. Helen Molnar, our new champion, will be back next time to have a go at $5,000. And I hope you'll be back, too. And I know you'll be back, too, because we got you chained to the tables, haven't we? Thank you. Gene Rayburn saying so long for Matt Dane 73.
Today's Constellation Prizes are Charm Glow Wax, a completely portable gas grill that goes anywhere. Instant flame without starter fluids with charcoal, Charm Glow products of Antioch, Illinois. And a West Clock. Direct reading digital dial light alarm clock, wood grain finish, lighted dial, backed by years of experience. West Clock's Italian Industries Company. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. Stay tuned for Secret Storm next.